During the 1992-93 season, Doug Gilmour acquired 95 assists and 127 points. He won the Selke Trophy as the league's best defensive forward, and also finished second to Mario Lemieux for the Hart Trophy as the league's most valuable player. During three rounds of the playoffs that year, he acquired another 35 points. But here are just a few of the many, many cheap shots he endured in the playoffs that year.
Pot bag coming out. Put it by Wilson. Gilmour. Everybody in the gardens holding their breath. Pat Burns, furious over there. Here's a shot, right on, and Joseph grabs it. Gilmour is on the leaf bench, and here's Burns. He cannot understand what is happening.
Well, he thinks it's a knee. One of those knee-to-knee collisions. Gilmour almost got out of the way, and all his weight was on his left leg. In the opinion of Andy Van Halleman, it's no penalty. There it is, he's pointing to his knee. And those knee-to-knee collisions are always dangerous. Gilmour got off under his own power. But you wouldn't expect anything else of a gritty Doug Gilmour. Let's have a look at it now. Gilmour tries to chip it by Brown, and Brown definitely comes out with the right leg and knocks Gilmour to the ice.
The Leafs coasting home to victory here in game one. Anderson comes in, Gilmour was hit inside the line by McSorley, and this is going to draw Clark and McSorley into a racket. They're going, throwing punches. Oh, Clark is nailing McSorley. Now McSorley comes back. Gilmour was hit inside the line. He's still down. He hasn't moved. Gilmour trying to get up. McSorley was grabbed by Clark, who threw that hit on Gilmour. And Clark and McSorley are flailing away each other. Two of the heavyweights of the league. And no nonsense here, they're going at it. McSorley has the sweater off, and Clark nails him with another uppercut. Now Clark gets hit, ducks away from one. McSorley now pounding away, and the two linesmen just scared to take a chance on getting in there, I guess. Finally they get in, but Clark came back to McSorley, and they went at it.
He wants to take everybody on.
The officials are having a tough time getting this one under control. McSorley goes to the dressing room.
And when Clark saw the hit by McSorley, he ran after him right away and started the battle. Gilmour appears to be all right. He gets up and goes over and wants to take on the LA bench. Well, it didn't take very long for this series to take on a bitter complexion, and here we are, not even finished game one yet. And I know McSorley elbowed, but I also know that Gilmour got on the trolley tracks, as Mr. Cherry often says, and you can't survive trying this. And Clark sees Gilmour go down and comes to his rescue right away. Doug Gilmour looks like he's all right. Pat Burns is screaming down behind the bench. I don't know whether he's talking to LA King players. No, he's not. He's talking to Melrose.
Look
and
out.
Burns is trying
Look
to get
out.
Down at Melrose. Behind the Leaf bench, there's Burns telling Melrose, if you want to play that way, you're going to have to go through me too. They should calm him down, though.
Wayne Gretzky's stick bob, I believe. And Carey Fraser's going to the linesman to ask him here. And wouldn't this be something if Wayne Gretzky was thrown out for a high stick? Not going to give him a penalty by the look of it. It certainly was accidental. But tell that to Gilmour. He's got to get his chin stitched up.